XRP, we start with 1 hour chart. Okay, if we refer to our analysis, when the price, we have been in trade from here, and when the price was within this correction, we mentioned about how to manage. And then from there, we mentioned if you want to look for sell, we need to get the correction. But this is the only way, I mean, this is the only correction we had. It. That means the only way was to trade. It was, only way we could trade was to trade this on 15 minutes. Okay, now we want to see what's the next and how we can trade it. Okay, as you can see, we had this sharp move and the price reverse. Okay, first of all, we move to daily chart. Okay, as we can see, based on daily chart, even if you refer to our analysis, after we get this down move, we mentioned maybe the price can reverse and be part of this correction. Okay, because at that, I mean, because we were mentioning if we get the drop, what we interested the price to retest this low, because at that time, if we can confirm this move is finished and we can look for next move. All right, now we want to see whether still we are within this correction, and this is the start of the up move. Okay, now in this case, we move to forward chart. As we can see, based on forward chart, we have been looking for this expanding, and after we get this down move, we mentioned maybe we get the reversal, and this is what we get. But the only thing is, what we get was really sharp. Okay, now the thing is, if you want to trade whether this is the correction for continuation or this one can tend to be a correction, that means still we can put this one in relative to this. Even we mentioned about this possibility in my last analysis, because this move already we have 1, 2, 3. Okay, maybe this one can tend to dip flat for one more drop, or also this one internally can give us a 1, 2, 3 for one more drop. Okay. That's why whatever I mentioned here, because what we were expected the price to continue and at least break this low, which is 0.39. Okay, because at that time, so you mentioned at least we can look for reversal. Okay, you know, the thing is whether this is a reversal, we cannot expect the price anymore to drop to 0.39, or we're getting the bigger correction. The reason I'm mentioning all these things, if you want to buy, we need to get the proper trade set up. And if I move to 1 hour chart, okay, from what we have right now, we don't have any trade setup, because if I want to look for this with a small correction, still we can expect the price move a bit higher. Okay, and this is what we need to do. I mean, if you want to have a trade, the only thing is ways to have entry above the top, whether we want to put above the shadow or here. Okay, this kind of the trade we can take it if there is, but we consider as a short term. But we are looking for is long term. That's why we made this one give us one more drop. If we get the one more drop, the next move, as long as the price haven't broke this low, we can consider for, I mean, buy with the breakout of the stop. But right now, whatever we have, if we get any trade, is only short term, unless this one turned to a correction similar to what I drew here. That's mean we don't have any trade set up right now. In this case, we just follow the chart, and it's best we wait to see what we get as a confirmation for next move. And if there is a continuation from here, if we get any small flag, we can look for buy, but any buy will be a short-term buy. As long as we get into the profit, we start to manage it, because we have been looking again for this, we were expecting this move to drop some more, at least to finish this fully based on what we have here for reversal. But whatever we have get, I think it's bigger correction. Okay, that's why we need to be quite careful. By the way, we don't have any trade set up for long term, and whatever we have, if we get this short term, and in this case, we just follow the chart. If I see any update, I will share. Thanks.